fuck? Why am I on top of a fucking tree? Laura!
What? How the hell am I gonna get down?
Asked and answered.
Where the hell are my clothes? You gotta be kidding me. Okay. Gotta find Laura. Should have just gone to the Harbinger Motel.
Table, help me.
Okay. Well, can't get much worse than it already is, right? Great. Just like the cartoons.
It's been off and on all night. It gives us a little time.
How do you figure?
They don't like water, remember?
Right. Oh, we should have just been swimming in the lake all night.
And die of hypothermia? No.
All right, well, we're good now.
Night's not over yet. These fuckers know we're in here, and they're coming back first chance they get.
Great news, okay.
All right, we gotta get a vantage point. Nice to put a name to a big, mean face. So what, you're like Mr. H's brother, I guess?
Who?
The big dude from earlier, when you and Ryan went to the radio hut. Mr. H's brother, I guess?
Right.
Jeez, I can see really struggling if they're begging for a dollar. heck is this?
I'm a happy, happy bunny!
Every dusk and dawn all through the summer. What doesn't kill you'll make you stronger. We're here to lead the way. Fuck mates for life, we're proud to say. Shout it Stroud and shout it loud. We're hacketeers. 2 months and you never learn the words? Showtime, motherfuckers.
Fuck this whole night. I just wish I could tell you I'm sorry. More than anything. Fuck. I just wanted one more night together. Is that too much to ask for? Shit. Stop crying, you big baby.
What the?
You play with me!
So what exactly happened 6 years ago?
There was a fire that wiped out dozens of people, and now there's werewolves and a ghost that roams the woods looking for her lost baby boy. Which I've just put together is Silas. Oh shit.
It's a long story.
No, it's not. There was a fire. Silas the wolf boy escaped, bit a bunch of your family. You failed to stop him.
Burn.
What happened in the past doesn't matter right now.
It kind of does, actually. We need to know what we're up against, at least.
What we're up against is a feral boy turned werewolf who for the last 6 years has avoided being found. No matter what we did. Every full moon we were out there looking. Every single one. Now the son of a bitch is finally here. So what we're up against is my only chance to end this thing for good.
So how do you even know where he is? How the hell are we gonna find him just driving down the middle of the road?
He's gotta be nearby. Let's look around.
Are you crazy?
Are we there yet?
You're okay.
Been better, but yeah.
Over here. Got some blood. Leads through there.
What the hell happened back here? Whoa.
This is where we went off the road 2 months ago.
You're trying to decide if you should shoot me in the head right now. Go ahead. If that's what you want, I won't stop you.
What?
Normally, I'd have werewolf's blood cover our scent, but I'm all out, so we're high risk. We could be killed. You ready to end this?
Let's fucking do this.
Go team!
all makes sense now.
You've got wolf blood?
Found it in the woods. Travis just reminded me. You should take it. There's not enough for the both of us.
No, I can't do that. It's yours.
You've been through a lot more than I have. Anyone deserves to get out of this alive, it's you.
Thanks. That means a lot.
Yeah, no worries. I guess.
Ugh, pungent. This has got some uncool vibes.
Podcast didn't do it justice.
You don't know the half of it.
This is where I saw her.
Her?
I thought Max hit her, but then I was out here and she was something else.
Who?
The woman. The old woman. She was saying something over and over again. Oh my god, she was saying Silas.
No, that's impossible. Who you're talking about?
I saw her too. In the run tunnels.
Eliza Voorhees. Silas's mother. I think.
Who was she?
She ran a traveling sideshow called Harem Scarum. Came here 6 years back. She kept her son in a cage. Called him Silas the Wolf Boy. Died in a fire. Some say she never left.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
We've been looking for Silas ever since.
How did the fire start? Really? You're still hiding stuff now?
You blew half the head off my niece, Kaylee Hackett. One of the kindest, gentlest souls to ever walk this earth. And all she wanted to do was help that little boy. Locked in a cage by that freak show witch.
What did she do?
She just wanted to help him.
Travis.
She convinced Caleb to start a fire. It was just a distraction. It's May Bales. Give him enough time to get Silas out of his cage and give him his freedom.
That's not what happened.
No. Because within minutes, everybody was dead. You ever see Hayburn? Liza? Whole crew? Kaylee managed to get Silas to freedom. But Caleb got bit in the process.
That's why you've been hunting him. Silas, I mean.
Every full moon for 6 fucking years.
Some hunter you are.
This is all that's left.
Jesus Christ.
Man. Any sign?
Negative.
I never saw any of this.
I didn't even know this was here.
Shit. I'm sorry, that was...
Close. We must be close.
Did you both
see it too?
Kinda wish I hadn't.
Same. What is it?
It's
Silas, the dog boy.
That must be it. Careful.
Jesus Christ.
Oh my God.
What's wrong?
What are you waiting for?
Shoot, you stupid girl!
Shoot.
Please, let's just go before we have to see him like that in human form.
It's too late for that.
I bet you think you have it all figured out. I bet you think you're fucking clever. I tried to help you. I tried to warn you. I even started to like you. Not now. Not after this. I will not forget what you made them do to my Silas. I've been with you all night, and I'm not about to stop now just because the night's come to an end. No. Whenever you hear a noise in the dark, a whisper from the shadows, the breath on the back of your neck, that's gonna be me. I'll be there. Now I will never leave you. I'll never leave you.
Could hide neath the wings of the bluebird as she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings and I rise, wipe the sleep out of my eyes. My shaven razor's cold and it stings. Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? You once thought of me as a white knight on his steed. Now you know how happy I can be. Starts and ends without dollar one to spend. But how much, baby, do we really need? Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a to a daydream believer and a home.
Bodies recovered in summer camp murder mystery. What do you make that, Anton?
Bad journalism? Murder mystery? Isn't that just an unsolved murder?
Yes, I suppose that is what most journalists would say. But perhaps the journalists of North Kill share my supernatural suspicions.
Yeah, I guess there wouldn't be much competition in North Kill. Probably not getting the best writers there.
Okay, can we at least start the podcast before you completely resign yourself to cynicism?
I thought we'd done the whole Hackett's Quarry thing.
Not this Hackett's Quarry thing.
What was this, like 3 months ago? Old news, dude.
Anton, introductions first. We are Bizarre Yet Bonafide, the podcast of the paranormal. I'm Grace.
And I'm Anton.
And together, we explore the possibility of supernatural involvement in real-life, everyday occurrences.
And that's exactly what they are, real-life, everyday occurrences.
With a shadow of spiritual, supernatural occurrences.
No.
Okay, so I hope you've got hat insurance, Anton, because I'm about to blow your mind.
Did you just ask if I had hat insurance?
Yes. It's responsible to insure those things which mean the most to you.
A hat.
Yes.
Okay, I know where your priorities lie. Go on.
Anyway, there actually is a real reason that we're coming back to Hackett's Quarry. There have been some developments, and I've sourced some information.
I remain skeptical, but I'm all ears. Under my hat.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Oh, God. Why? Why are you smiling? Stop it. I hate it.
Why? I had braces. I have to make use of them sometimes.
You do have very pretty teeth.
Thank you. That's something that a lot of podcast listeners might not know about me. So, it just so happens I've got someone on the inside. So, today's episode is going to have a bit of a show-and-tell vibe to it.
Who do you inside? The inside of where?
What?
You know someone on the inside?
Don't we all have someone on the inside? You know, an inner critic that says, stop doing a podcast. No one's listening.
You should listen to that voice, Grace.
Okay, well, what I really meant is, let's call it an anonymous donation. You know, we're not the only ones who flagged this as a bizarre situation. Someone actually reached out to us. They sent us a package.
Did you? You didn't open it. I don't trust anyone who listens to this show.
Oh, I couldn't wait to open it. Surprise!
Anonymous donation.
Okay, you've always promised me since day one of this podcast that if you could see true evidence, you will consider all options, right? Did you not say that?
I did say that, yes.
I mean, I know you...
Knowing for a fact that we would never see any evidence, I did say that.
Okay, well, we've been sent information and we need to decide whether it's bizarre or bona fide.
Okay, fine. Let's do this. For anyone listening at home, we are about to open a package from a mysterious person who listens to this show. If you are the one who sent us whatever it is, congrats, you got us.
Sorry, really, there's just so much tape on the package. Sorry, can you help me with this? Do you have like a key I could like slice at it with?
No, I don't want you to dull my key. Just use your fingers.
Just give me your fucking key, Anton.
No.
Give me your fucking key.
No. Get your own key.
It's not like you lock your door.
Of course I lock my door.
What are you hiding?
What am I hiding? Do you not lock your doors?
No, I have nothing to hide.
You think that ghosts are real, but you don't lock your doors?
No, ghosts couldn't open my doors. They could walk through my walls, Anton.
Okay, you need to be more concerned with murderers.
Take a look. Apparently, they found another body.
Whoa! You can't just show me a picture of a dead body. You got to tell me before you're gonna do that.
Okay, then let's take this over. Anton, can I show you a picture of a dead body?
No!
I can't work with that, Anton.
Okay, fine. Yes, it's a dead body. Okay, what is this? What am I looking at?
It's one of the hikers that went missing. Do you remember that?
Yes, that's the true part of the story.
Yeah. Ed Benson was his name. He was drowned in the lake.
Okay, drowned or was drowned?
Now you're getting grammatical.
I'm not getting grammatical. If you drown, you just went swimming and you drowned. If he's been drowned, then someone drowned him.
Well, then I think I implied precisely what I meant to imply. Now, of course, I can't verify this info,
but... Of course you can't.
What, do I have like a history of not verifying?
Yes, it's fake.
Okay, but I feel very strongly that he was drowned.
Okay, well, do the police know about this? Are the Hackett family suspects?
Okay, I like that you are getting into this. Here's the thing. The newspaper says this guy's still missing, right? He looks pretty fucking found in this picture.
Okay, yeah, I mean, he's not missing, he's right there, but
yeah.
Why? Why would they say he's still missing?
Because it is a conspiracy! A cover-up! Don't you see? They're all in on it.
Who's all in on it? The Hackett family?
The Hackett family, the North Kill Gazette. I told you I've been suspicious of them from the start.
Okay, so there's the one hiker, he's dead. What about the other one?
Anne Radcliffe? Still missing. Who knows how many bodies are still down there, though.
I don't know, this is pretty inconclusive. I'm sorry that the guy drowned, but this kind of seems like a big to-do over nothing.
Or is it a big undo of something, which is what a cover-up is?
Okay, you can't just twist my words like that.
Okay, so I anticipated your skepticism, which is why I saved this little gem for next.
Finally.
Quarry and hit great heights of success before Septimus Hackett, classic bad guy name, the seventh son of the Trappers, the number seven, has great supernatural powers, closed the mine down.
Okay, so then they only had the land to live off.
Yes, you say only, but this land actually spans acres. That's a lot of forest, a lot of unexplored darkness.
Ooh, okay, a great place to hide, to have all these dark secrets for this strange, reclusive family.
Mm-hmm. And this is where we start to get a little more into paranormal territory.
Okay, here we go.
Acres and acres of haunted woods.
If you say so.
Welcome to Bizarre Yet Bonafide, the podcast of the paranormal.
Welcome back to Bizarre Yet Bonafide. Anton, today I'm actually going to pass you some light writing.
Okay, you're going to make me read this?
Mm-hmm.
All right, this is...
What you're seeing now is a copy of a letter that Kaylee Hackett wrote to her grandma. Allegedly.
All right, this seems like more of a you job, but I suppose
right,
I can read this.
Right, but I feel like if some of the evidence comes from your mouth, it will have more clout.
Right, okay, here we go. Gammy, how long we gonna drag this shit out?
Mm.
I know family is the most important thing, but I wanna know what's outside the forest, outside this damn house and camp, and I sure as hell know that ain't about to happen because of who we are. Maybe we can explain what's going on. Fucking show people. Then they'll know we got no control over it. I know you just trying to protect us, but one day you won't be here no more, and right now it feels like we stuck in a dark hole. I can't sleep, Gammy, or if I do, I dream about that fucking fire. We were just dumbass kids back then. I wish it never happened. Love, K, XOXO. That took a turn.
Yes. Dream about that fucking fire. Does that not read as the haunted scribblings of someone who saw something that they shouldn't have seen?
Yeah, no, I'm fully creeped out.
She was clearly going through some stuff.
And this is legit?
I mean, I don't know why someone would fake it. Then again, I can't verify any of this. So, you've got to suspend your disbelief slightly.
Man, this poor girl.
Ah, there was something going on, something eating away at her, and that's what I want to explore.
Okay, well, consider my disbelief suspended, for now.
So, I don't think that's gonna be a problem for this next one.
Oh God, why? Holy shit, this is a cease and desist letter.
And it's addressed to us.
Dude, why didn't you tell me about this?
Well, it was never actually sent.
That's mad shit, fam.
What?
Signed by Travis Hackett.
We're not doing anything illegal.
Aren't we?
Think about it.
I guess it wasn't technically sent to us.
Cease and desist letters come from people hiding stuff.
Hmm. Okay.
And next we have this empty vial thing.
Now, to me, empty implies that it was once full.
Samesies.
Bloodstains, maybe? Filled with blood?
Looks that way.
Freaky. Some kind of ritual thing?
Do I detect a hint of belief?
Love a good ritual. Kind of fucked up that these guys know who we are, though.
Okay. Anton, what you see next pretty much confirms it.
That you're a crackpot conspiracy theorist, a loser?
Shit went down at Hackett's Quarry this summer. Real supernatch shit.
See, you always say things like this, and you're always overselling it.
You always have to oversell something to even sell it. That's capitalism, baby.
All right.
Okay, this is actual footage from one of the trail cams in Hackett Woods.
Oh, cool, a camera in the middle of the woods? Did they find a squirrel?
Be honest, if it was mounted on a mountain bike, you would watch that whole video.
Yes, of course. Is there a mountain bike involved?
No, but take a look anyways.
Okay. That is a bear?
That is a bear to you? There is no way that is a bear.
Okay, well, a skinny bear?
Okay, this could be some of the clearest footage of something like this I've ever seen.
Right, it's kind of blurry, though.
Blurry and convincing. Sometimes the truth can't be contained within the lines.
Right, yeah. And also, footage is pretty easy to fake. Technology is super scary.
Yeah, but what the hell were the Hacketts doing with footage like this anyways?
Huh, that's a good point. Weird little video of a skinny bear. Yeah, I don't know.
Again, you keep saying a skinny bear. Have you seen a skinny bear?
Yes, that's
bears
very sad.
Oh.
Yeah, polar bears, it's hard for them to find food sometimes. Don't feel too bad for them, though. They're nasty.
Okay, but putting the Hackett family aside for a moment, there's more to this. Are you ready for some real spooky shit?
I'm ready for real spooky shit. I don't know if you can provide it, but please try.
Don't get too freaked out.
I'll try my hardest.
Okay. Do you want to hold my hand?
No.
Okay. Do you need someone to comfortingly pat your back?
Please just say what you're going
to
say.
Do you want me to turn all the lights on so you don't
I don't want you to do anything. I want you to say what you have. Okay, so what's this? What are we looking at now?
A photo by one of the counselors, Emma Mountebank, downloaded from her phone.
My God, is this real?
Well, that is what we're here to discuss.
Okay, this looks shopped. I mean, doesn't it?
Okay, but if you downloaded photos from my phone, yes, they would all be shopped as well. There would be a filter on it to make my eyes look big and cheeks look pink. But I don't even think that has even any of those filters. Look at the eyes and tell me that's not real danger.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah, weird, bizarre, yet bona fide.
What the hell happened?
More than we are being told.
Yeah?
There's something else, too.
Okay.
Look at what happens when I put it through a negative filter.
Whoa! Okay, what is that?
It's her! The Hag of Hackett's Quarry! See? Full circle!
No. That could be anything.
Like what? Please, try to explain.
I don't know. What's that thing? There's this thing, it makes your mind, you see faces and stuff. There's people, there's Jesus shows up on toast every once in a while. This could be whatever.
Well, I don't need to hear too much more about your breakfast, but I can't believe that you're still questioning this. You're doubting your own cynicism now, though, I can tell. I can smell the doubt that you usually apply to other things on yourself. Pixar didn't happen, right? Well, pics so did happen.
No, pics you can fabricate. Experiences you can't. I would need to see the Hag of Hackett's Quarry myself.
Well, if you want to go to North Kill with me,
no,
I actually have a really
good
relationship.
I don't. Okay, I believe you.
Okay, but you know what? I have something that couldn't be fabricated.
Claw marks in a wall. I could make this right now.
Really?
Just find me a wall, I'll take a fork, and just go to town.
Wow, what an artisan.
Thanks.
Well, to me, this isn't actually overtly supernatural, because it could have just been, you know, an animal or someone's angry parrot. But it'd be unfair not to discuss.
Why?
Because the audience has come to expect a certain length of the podcast, so we actually have to sometimes do a little bit of filler.
Yeah, that's true. We don't have much to talk about.
Well, whoever did reach out thought it was worth sharing.
There's a chance this is all just a prank, you know?
It was just a prank, Anton!
Who even are you? It's probably just some teenager who's making fun of you. It's probably that dude who came on and gave us a one-star review.
I would love to tell you that that's implausible, but a teenager making fun of me is probably the most familiar experience of my life.
Moving on! How about this? Tell me this isn't freaky as shit.
Oh! Is that skin?
Skin, fur, whatever you want to call it, really.
Okay, it looks human. Is that a tattoo?
I don't think so. Or maybe a really bad one.
Wait, is it?
Apparently, this belongs to whatever creatures supposedly caused all this.
Okay, do we have the actual thing? Did they capture it? Can I see it in its weird flesh, so to speak?
You want to touch the flesh.
I want to touch the flesh.
Well, fortunately, the person who sent this to me was smart enough to know that it would be dangerous to steal the actual evidence, not to mention they might suspect that you, Anton, would hide it away so as to sabotage this legitimate investigation.
Right, I am known for destroying evidence. Convenient that we can't see the real deal, huh?
Come on, man, you're desperate not to believe.
If there's you have to assume it's not real, Occam's razor.
But look at everything we've seen. Put it all together, objectively.
So those kids, the ones who survived.
Yeah.
Why aren't they coming out with all this? Kids are always on the internet. These kids actually have something interesting to say. Why aren't they telling anyone?
I don't know, but someone did come out with it. Whoever gathered all this info and submitted it to me.
Right, do we know who this is? This could just be a teenager making fun of you.
No, a teenager couldn't possibly do this.
I think you're being cyberbullied.
This is carefully curated information. Someone went into the depths of a dark mystery and retrieved all this information and gave it to me. Someone smart, someone clever, someone genius. And it's all been hushed. And if what we're looking at has any truth to it, then I'm not surprised. I think we've been contacted to expose it.
So, these kids who survived this, they're just out there living their lives? I mean, that seems weird to me. I wonder what it took to keep them quiet.
Whatever really happened, they'll be carrying it like a curse wherever they go.
So you really still don't know who sent this to you?
Nope. Complete anonymity. But the photos, the way they're all set out, it looks like evidence. Like they came from somewhere, I don't know, official.
Okay.
What? Why?
Why didn't you tell me about this before?
What? I've been telling you about
this it This is now. Actual stuff, Grace. We have to take this to the police.
Okay. So, then you believe
it. I don't know. Maybe.
You never believe anything. Why is this any different?
Because it's starting to make sense, okay? Our name on that letter, the missing hikers, the family secrets. When you put it all together, it's certainly something.
Someone's trying to tell us something?
And we should probably stop recording this right now and tell the authorities, right?
Heck no, it's just getting juicy. And who says we're not the authorities?
I do. We're not the authorities.
What? It's not like we have a moral duty to take this evidence to the authorities.
We do.